2013 is the 50th anniversary of Lamborghini, and it's only fitting that this year's Lamborghini Blancpain Super Trofeo has its world final at Vallelunga, on the outskirts of Italy's capital in Rome. Throughout the year, we've seen some stunning racing in all three regional Super Trofeo championships. The Lamborghini Blancpain Super Trofeo Europe crowning its new champions at Hockenheim on the 22nd of September, with Swiss driver Laurent Jenny from the Alto Vitesse Garage Afolda taking the amateur crown, and Italy's Auto Carrozzeria Imperiale Andrea Amici triumphing over the winner of the last two seasons, the Swiss driver Cedric Lima. The North American series ended on the 20th of October at the Auto Club Speedway in Fontana in California. GMG Racing's Tom O'Gara taking amateur honours, with Change Racing, brand new racing team Change Racing, as Kevin Conway, ex-NASCAR, the Pro-Am title. And the Lamborghini Blancpain Super Trofeo Asia series finished just 2 weeks ago in Macau, with the pairing of Max Weiser and Jiang Xin, the Pro-Am champions, with China's duo of Zheng Tin and Stephen Lin taking amateur honours. So now, some of the best of all three series gathered together here at Vallelunga to fight it out for overall honours. Hopefully, we've got Clive Ritchie and Daniele Cariotti in the pit lane as our pit lane reporters. Haven't heard a word from them just yet, so if they can hear me, just remember that I'm watching you. Pit stops throughout the race. It's a 50-minute race, but we have a mandatory pit stop of 84 seconds for everybody. Now, there are most of the drivers are single drivers, but we do have some teams which are pairing up, and the first pairing is on pole. In first qualifying, it was Andrea Amici, the European champion, who was fastest, with Zanardi and Galliani behind him. Andrew Palmer, the American, the best American in first free practice, in fourth place. Brilliant stuff on that. And Andrea Palmer in fifth. Second free practice, it was the Zaug de Nora duo, who are on pole here, who started to really fight through. And the Frenchman, Engelbert, in second place in free practice. But in qualifying, it was, again, Zaug and de Nora who managed to snatch pole position. Andrea Amici, with his last lap, got into second place. Then Gagliardini in third, and Alberto Viberti in fourth place. Andrew Palmer, the best of the North Americans, in fifth. And Yap Tanaga, the best of the Asians, in sixth place. Then Zenardini, Taniguchi, Tanka, and Andrea Palmer rounding out the top 10. So the grid goes like this. As they're going round under the pace car at the moment, because all through the weekend we've had storms and rain, and it was only just as the cars were starting to roll out of the pit lane that the clouds sort of parted a little bit and we got a little bit of sun. Now, it's still raining out there, but just a little bit, not as much as it has been all morning. We're under yellow flag at the moment, and the grid goes like this. Starting off for at the front is Adrian Zaug, the South African. He's the pro driver of the pairing, because Federico De Nora will be taking over from him after the pit stop. We fully expect Adrian Zaug to run away at the front at the start. It's going to be difficult, though, because Andrea Amici, right next to him in the Imperiale Lamborghini, number 54, so it's number 3 at the front, number 54 alongside. Second row of the grid, Andrea Gagliardini. Let's get the names right. This is going to be fun. Number 14, alongside Alberto Viberti. The youngster, Alberto Viberti, is only, I think he's about 19 years old. And I'm looking at the Italian commentator standing next to me, and I put it thumbs up here. And they're looking at Alberto and thinking, this guy could put the cat among the pigeons. But there is another youngster, the 20-year-old Andrew Palmer, who's here with his dad. And he said his dad, Andrew, was the main man who designed what the car looks like. And it's chrome and red. I mean, this one you can't miss. He said he designs it like a video game. So Andrew Palmer, who came out just basically for his very, very first race during the American Series in a car at the Virginia International Raceway, took pole position and took a race win and a fourth in his first time in a car. So watch out for this guy as well. He's on the third row alongside Johnson Yap Tanaga, the Indonesian Asian. And Yap Tanaga not taking the car out. He's the amateur driver. It's a professional driver of the team. You can see there are some of these cars that are having two drivers, a professional driver. Manabu Arido, the Japanese Super GT driver, will be starting off in the number 263 car. On row 4, Mirko Zanardi, for Benaldi Motorsport, and Yukinori Taniguchi for Lamborghini Osaka, number 212. Row 5 is Roberto Tanca, another of the Imperiale cars. He's an amateur driver, number 72, and pretty good for him as well, because both Zanardi in front of him and Tanca are both amateur drivers, and not too bad to be on the fourth and fifth row of the grid. Alongside Roberto Tanca on row 5 is Andrea Palma. Now, Andrea Palma, if you might remember the GT Sprint series of last year, he basically ran away with the entire series, scoring, I think, 7 races, race wins on a trot. He's racing for Imperiale, number 27, on the fifth row of the grid. Then Roberto Cerveso and Tom O'Gara, the amateur champion from the States, he's riding alongside James Sofronas, and James Sofronas, who's a team owner of GMG, he will be starting for that car. That's number 169. Behind him, Abkazova and Akihiko Nakaya. Still under the yellow flag as you're going around, so I think we're doing 3 laps behind the pace car, and it looks like the cars are going to start in line astern order because of the state of the track. It's been raining almost constantly. If you have a look right at the back, look for number 77. It's a black car with an orange stripe down, and that is Engelbert. Now, Engelbert has had to start from the rear of the grid, and I haven't been told exactly why, because this is a pro driver. He's a French driver for Aviatrax Lamborghini, and he's having to start from right at the back, so I expect a lot of movement for Engelbert through the pack from the beginning of this race. He is the sole driver in that car, and he's a pro driver, so expect a lot of movement from the back. I'm also expecting to see something from Jake Rattenbury. Now, Jake Rattenbury is the sole British driver in the series, number 33. He's also right at the back, but he's had problems as well. They had to change an entire gearbox on the car because they had gearing problems, brought it in, and then went out just to test it and found exactly the same problem. And they think it's a selector. They thought it was a selector on the outside of the gearbox, so they brought Lamborghini in to change that. And Jake was out, the only car out this morning, in the early morning light, going around trying to see if the car was any good. As far as I could tell, it seemed to have no problems. So Jake Rattenbury, unfortunately for him, amateur driver, only 20 years old, starting from the rear of the grid. It's going to be a lot of fun. Still going down the grid as we were on row 7. Shota Abkazova, let's get that right, racing for Lamborghini Germany. The Russian is there. And then Akihiko Nakaya alongside, he would have been alongside Kuki Yoshikura, but Kuki Yoshikura is not racing. So it's Nakaya all on his own. As they come round onto the infield section of Vallelonga, this 4,085 meter track. This will be the start of the race when they come round. Now, you're going to expect the South African, Adrian Sauer, to run away from the front. That's really what he wants to do. Andrea Amici wants to keep him within sight. Doesn't really need to take him at the moment, because he does know that when they come in for their 84-second pit stop, Federico De Nora, the amateur, will be taking over from Adrian. Adrian's an incredibly quick South African. Watch out for him. It's the yellow top, white car, basically, with red flashes around the wheels behind him. The white car with the long stripe in Italian colours, that is Andrea Amici. And behind them are the two composite motor cars, number 47, Alberto Viberti, and Andrea Galliani. Watch out for them coming out the final corner. They'll want to do something, as will Andrew Palmer. And they're going across the line now, and straight away, Adrian Sauer, under the green flag, has already opened up a gap over Andrea Amici. We'll have to watch as they go through, and all the cars basically trying to get up to speed now. There's a big gaps already opening up, because they weren't as close as they wanted to be. Right at the back, I can see, finally, Engelbert taking Rattenbury, I think, just at the final on the main straight. So that's where they're going at the moment. But watch out for Adrian Sauer. Adrian Sauer out in front. And that's where he'll want to be. We've got these tiny little 7-inch monitors at the moment, and it's very, very grey out there, so it's going to be pretty difficult to find out what's going on. The name coming up on the screen is De Nora, but because we've got a two-man team here, it's not De Nora in the car at the moment, it's Adrian Sauer. So if you're watching a live timing, that's Adrian Sauer out in front at the moment, and Andrea Amici behind him, which is pretty good indeed. Galliani's got there. Viberti, basically, we're all in grid order at the moment. Andrew Palmer in fifth place. Manabu into sixth. good for him. And that's where he should be as well. Zanardi, Taniguchi, Tanker, Andrea Palmer in 10th place. So we'll wait for them to come across the stripe. Well, we'll find out what's going on. Having a look in from inside one of the cars at the moment. We've already got a couple of spinners out there. Trying to figure out who it is at the moment. And I think that is... Let's have a look. Bum, 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 bum. Know where he is at the moment. That might be Taras Policek in a Vortex competition car, the orange car right at the back there. I think he spun out as well, but he's also had problems with another car. We'll find out what car that was a little bit later as they come across the stripe. Adrian Zaug already starting to stretch his lead a little bit. Andrea Amici in second place. Gagliardini and Viberti across the line. 50-minute race with an 84-second pit stop, mandatory pit stop for everybody. And a big fight right at the back of the field, and that's Engelbert already starting to move up the field, trying to get past Spirit and off number 99, so he's already taken about six places from the back. That's number seven, and it was Taras Polishuk, I thought, that spun around, and he's the last car across the stripe, so he's in last place at the moment. So... South African Adrian Zaug out in front and doing what he's been paid to do, the pro driver, to run away as quickly as possible. Then Andrea Amici in second place, Gagliardini in third, Viberti fourth, Manabu fifth, and Andrew Palmer. It's going to be a bit confusing because we've got Andrea Palmer, who's the Italian, and he's down in 10th place, and Andrew Palmer, who's a North American, and he's currently in 6th place. And Zanardini, Taniguchi, Tanker, there's Palmer in 10th place, and Seveso Abkazava in 12th, Nakaya, Mori, Conway. Kevin Conway way down the order in 15th place. Now, this is a North American champion, and he should have been a lot further up than that. Engelbert now into 18th place. So he's past Malagamua. Malagamua is one of the top Asian drivers out there. He's from Sri Lanka, and yet he's down in 19th place, so they've been having problems as well. Jake Rattenbury, at least he's a bit further up than he was in 20th place. And Sophronas, the American, basically the team owner, 169, Sophronas, of GMG Racing, he'll be alongside Tom Magara, and Sophronas out, and we expected him to go a lot quicker than he's been doing, and yet he's down in 21st place and almost last. The only one behind him is Polichuk, who we did see spin out. So it might have been Polichuk and Sophronas together who had that problem at the start. Well, we'll see what happens. The one person you've got to keep your eye on, though, is Engelbert, because when he came across the line last time, he'd really made a move on all these cars. He was up to 18th place and will really want to start to move from the back. Number 33, I'm just looking, going across the line, that's Jake Rattenbury. And unfortunately, he is now second to last, with Polichuk right last behind him. Having a look, trying to get the screens going here. And so Adrian Zaug, so far the race is going the way he wanted to go. He's still maintaining his gap over Andrea Amici by just over 2 seconds at the moment. And Gagliardini behind him by 1.2 seconds. So the gap's opening up at the front here, and Manabu, or Max, we'll call him, Max Arido, not doing too badly at all in fourth place. Andrew Palmer's chasing him mightily, though, but still just a second, just under a second behind Arido in fourth place. 263 is Arido, watch out for him. And Andrew Palmer will be really feeling his oats around here. The red and silver car, Andrew Palmer. Now, having a look at the front, Adrian Zaug is not getting away from Andrea Amici, nowhere near as much as you'd think he should do. Andrea Amici is starting to feel that he can maybe push Zaug down and maybe even take him for overall lead before he gets through. The first two going through, number 54 is Andrea Amici, the Imperiale car, and they've got quite a gap now over Gagliardini, who's another 2 seconds or so down. Then it's Manabu and Palmer, so Arido Manabu into fourth place, Palmer into fifth. It's Alberto Viberti, who's had a little bit of a problem. He's down to sixth place now, just in front of Zanardi. Andrew Palmer's up into eighth place. That's doing very good. We don't have split times on all of them, but it doesn't really matter because I'd want colour split times so I know who's going faster than they were before. Last lap, 1 minute 48.6 for Adrian Zhao. Amici haven't got his lap times yet, and I really want that. Don't have Andrea Amici's lap time, which is the only one of the lap times that we don't have, and I just want to see how much quicker he was than Zhao through that last lap. Still don't have that. Gagliardini, 150, 149 for Orrido. So it's Adrian Zhao who's put in a good time. He's still ahead. We're looking at the infield now of Adrian Zhao coming through. And still pretty close. And right behind them, Andrew Palmer is really being put under a little bit of pressure here. It's not Viberti behind him at the moment. I think it might be Manabu that he's fighting with. So we'll have a look at that as they come round into the infield section. Four-wheel drive cars. So they should be able to handle this fairly well. Looking at Engelbert. He's still moving up the order, not as quickly as I thought. I think he's into 15th place at the moment. The Frenchmen were looking hard at him. 2 litres have gone through. That gap is still opening up now. 5 seconds between Gagliardini in third place and Adrian Zhao at the top. But it's still just... the gap has opened up a little bit between Zhao and Amici. And those two really battling at the front here. Just got one car going through the pit lane at the moment. Number 47. That's Alberto Viberti. So it looked like a pit lane drive-through for Alberto Viberti there. So even though he dropped back, he's been dropping back a lot more, the youngster. So poor old Viberti on the composites motor team. He's an amateur, but he's a very, very quick amateur. Jake Rattenbury and Jussi going through and still almost in last place, but I think they've dropped 2, 3, 4 at the moment, so we're going to look for them. Boom, 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 boom. I think it might have been Top Speed Racing's Yoshimori right at the back there. Not too sure about that. We'll see next time they come through. Yeah, 264 is Yoshimori. So he's had a bit of a problem and dropped right down to the bottom of these 22 cars on track at the moment. And still Adrian Zhao still maintaining his lead over Andrea Amici. Nobody else in the pit lane at the moment. So far, all of the cars going well. Looking at Zhao now, he's still keeping that gap between Andrea Amici at the front. And I think they're maintaining position because there's not much difference now between them and Gagliardini behind them as they cross the line. There goes Adrian Zhao. Then Amici. Gagliardini, next one across the line. Number 14. Palmer right behind him. And Max Orrido, Manabu Orrido. Manabu Orrido from the Super GT. Lamborghini Jakarta is the team name they're driving under today. He's partnered with Johnson Yaptenaga, who had a pretty good result at Macau, 13th at Macau last time out. So look out for them. Top Speed Racing is the entrant. Lamborghini Jakarta, the team. As we watch them around the track, it's still Adrian Zhao, number 77 on your screen at the moment. That's Engelbert, Dimitri Engelbert, the Frenchman, having to start from the back row of the grid and still trying to fight his way through. Got somebody just coming into pit lane. I'm not hearing from my pit lane reporters at the moment. And because of the rain smeared the windows at the moment, we don't know who's just come into pit lane. And it's pretty far up, so I can't actually tell from here. Can't see the number. Good news is, though, and there's another one that's just come through as well. So we've got two people coming down to pit lane. That looks like maybe it's not one of the composite cars. That's number 22. So that's Shota Abkhazova, who's just pulled into the pit lane. And one of the team members goes, gink, cut the car. Pit lane is now open. So these people are actually doing their pit stops. Pit lane window is open, but Shota Abkhazova, they are pushing the car away. So I think there's definitely a problem for the Russian, the number 22, who's gone in there. Andrew Palmer right on the tail of Gagliardini and really having a fight for third place. The red and silver car in fourth place. Andrew Palmer starting to push the Italian in front of him, number 14. And Andrea Gagliardini on the composite car, the red, the black and basically a black car with a silver one, is in third place, and that's one of the fights going on. Number 47, which is the Alberto Viberti, now dropped down to 10th place. Yeah, Shota is out, the car's been pushed to the side. Now we've just got a couple of team members looking at it, but nothing seems to be happening for that. So I think we've lost one of the entrants at the moment. The rest of them, well, they're doing pit stops as we speak. Still waiting for the leaders to come in, though. Adrian Zaug and Andrea Amici. Having a look at number 99, Mikhail Spiridonov from Lamborghini, Germany, the Russian. Don't have too much information on Spiridonov, but I can tell you he's in 12th place at the moment, just in front of Malagamua, Dilantha Malamagua, which is Malamaguba, that's it, which is quite a mouthful actually. He's from Sri Lanka, and he is the unofficial racing ambassador to Japan. He's spent a lot of his time in Japan. A little bit of a picture break up there. So with the pit lane window open, and would have been nice to hear from Clive Ritchie and Daniele Cariotti, who are down there in the pit lane, but I'm getting nothing through from them at the moment. So a little bit of a technical problem, which we hope to fix a little bit later on. Number 34 on your screen. It's Zanardini. Not too good for him. Mirko Zanardini, one of the Bonaldi Motorsports team, started off on the fourth row of the grid, but he's pretty well down in 18th place. So not a good day's racing for that man. Top Speed Racing's Manubu Orido, the yellow car that you just saw there. He's been doing Super GT in Japan, not too shabby as well. And he's the pro driver of the pair, so when he comes in, he'll be handing over to Johnson Yaptenaga, the Indonesian. He's had, a good season in Macau. Palmer and Gagliardini still in their battle over third place, and I still think Gagliardini's still into it. Yep. We're just having a look at the infield, and Gagliardini trying to hold off Andrew Palmer, the American. I didn't expect Kevin Conway to do better than he's doing. He's in 12th place behind Malagamua. And Sofronas is in front of them at the moment. So James Sofronas for GMG Racing, Global Motorsports Group Racing, not doing too badly as well. Sofronas in the 169 car. Red and white Gallardo. These are all LP570 four-wheel drive cars, so the rain not too much of a problem for them at the moment. Number 99 just exiting pit lane. That will be Mikhail Spiridonov from Ekaterinburg in Russia. He's been racing with the Porsche Carrera Cup recently and racing now for Team Germany, Team Lamborghini Germany. Spiridonov down the order in 16th place, just out of the points. Well, in fact, quite a few out of the points. Points do matter in this race. It doesn't matter whether you've got a pro in a car and they've got an amateur co-driver, they will be classed as a pro. So their points will go through to pro, to the pro leaderboard. The amateurs will have a different leaderboard at the end of this race. A lot of people now in the pits. Number 114 just coming through. So Andrew Palmer going out of the pits right now. He's probably done his pit stop. And a lot of the times will change now. A lot of the positions will change. And Andrea Amici basically has done what he needs to do. Number 3 just goes through our screen. So the Adrian Zaug has just gone through. Number 54, Andrea Amici's just gone through. Both within touch of each other. And Adrian Zaug has not been able to run away from Andrea Amici. That's a big deal because Adrian has to hand over to an amateur driver, whereas Andrea Amici just has to come in, do his 84-second pit stop, and then get out again. And he'll be, you know, that space that he is at the moment behind the amateur driver in front of him, and should, all things going well, take the lead here. So it's Adrian Zaug, number 3, out in front of the moment. Andrea Amici, number 54, the white car with the stripe down the side in Italian colours. Then Gagliardini, and then Manabu Orido in fourth place, Engelbert into fifth. But a lot of these people haven't come in for their pit stops just yet. We're seeing a lot of people going out for their pit stops. So at the moment, positions not set in stone, because a lot of people will be dropping out of their positions. And looking good at the moment for Orido, Manabu, and Engelbert, of course, the Frenchman, but they do have to come in and do their pit stops, whereas people like Andrew Palmer, who's already out, done his pit stop, looks like he's in ninth place at the moment, but there are a lot of people in front of him who have yet to do their pit stops. So there's a lot going on at the moment here. Adrian Zaug, though, it's worthwhile having a look at him. 27-year-old, born in Singapore, the South African and Swiss, basically South African Swiss race car driver. Fourth overall last year, third overall this year. But it's always because he would have been a lot further up if he'd had a better co-driver. And his co-driver is an amateur, not as quick, anywhere near as quick as Adrian Zaug. And still doing very, very well to get third overall in the European season this year. Looking at a lot of people, one of the change racing cars going out, 129, which is Kevin Conway. He's done his pit stop, had 4 wins and 4 podiums in the North American category, which they had one in Ontario as well, which was great for them. The orange and black car of Kevin Conway, 129, has just gone out. Change Racing is a brand new team this year, been created specially to contest the Lamborghini Blancpain Super Trofeo series. And the 3 series have come together here at Vallelonga in great style as well. Still, Adrian Zaug and Andrea Amici still to come in for their pit stops. Having a look at the top of the pit lane. Haven't seen them come in at the moment. Number 54 just going out. Andrea Amici, so he's done his pit stop. He's from Albano Lazio, which is local, so he knows his track very well. In fact, Albano Lazio is the same little village as Piero Taruffi came from, and this track is named after Piero Taruffi, who basically designed it. So he should know the track incredibly well. There's 4,085 meter Vallelonga track, very, very tight in section, and the final corner, which is Roma, encouraging you to put your foot down the main straight down to Curvone, where a lot of people could have problems, and so far nobody's had a problem here. So the only car that I can see out at the moment is Shota Abkazova's number 22, still parked up, not doing anything, but it's not, I still think we've got a little bit of rain coming down. It's not as heavy as it's been all weekend, but still no dry line appearing on the track. And still a lot of people waiting their time in pit lane. Finally released, 269 goes out. Top Speed Racing's Zen Low. So Dilantha Malagamua is handed over to the Malaysian Zen Low. He hasn't had too bad results either. Second and fourth in Malaysia, seventh and fifth in Korea, and fourth and third in Fuji, ninth at Macau. But he's the slower of the two drivers. Well, let's see what he can do here. Number 269, Zen Low, and he's gone out in 12th place. We do know that Adrian Zaug has come in. Sure, I saw his car in the pit lane, but he might have gone out now, so I think it's Federico De Nora who's gone out with the car. We're waiting for all the... Now, I could be confused, because the same team, the Bernaldi team, have very, very similar colours on their cars. But as you can see, conditions not ideal here. You could say that, in fact, they're absolutely horrible. The track has been rained on constantly the entire weekend, and it's very, very slippery out there. Four-wheel drive is really good for that, though, because you can do a lot more with four-wheel drive in these conditions. But again, if you overbrake, if you try a little bit too hard, if you put your foot down a little bit too hard, all sorts of things can happen. I haven't seen too many people in the kiddie litter at the moment. Number 99 going across the stripe at the moment. There's Burudinov into 11th place. And looking at the gaps now, well, Federico De Nora out on track at the moment. He's pit out, but Andrea Amici has already gone out before him. And first lap, 153.6. Time to get up to speed on the track that he's not too knowledgeable about at the moment, but everybody's been out practicing in these damp conditions, so not a problem with that at the moment. So the name has changed and it says that Adrian Zaug's out, but it's not, because it's the other way around. So they have different transponders on. The drivers will have transponders which will tell the timing screen who is out there, so they've obviously got the wrong transponders on. It just happens that way. It's not. It's Federico De Nora, who's still showing in first place at the moment. Even on the timing screen, if you might be watching live timing on the internet, it says Adrian Zaug. It's not. It's Federico De Nora. So the transponders have been transposed, as it were. Andrea Amici still in second place. Last lap, 2 minutes, but Andrea Amici, 1:53. It was an out lap for Federico De Nora. Doesn't matter that it's a 2 minutes, it's an out lap for him. So his next lap, hopefully he'll get up to speed as soon as possible, because at the moment, on timing, he still leads this race. Andrea Amici, though, will know who's in front of him. He'll have done his 84-second pit stop, and that was the man he'll be chasing. Gagliardini still in third place. Andrew Palmer, the American, the young American, still in fourth place. Zenardini behind him. Max Aurobou in sixth place. Alberto Viberti starting to move his way up the order. He's number 47 into seventh place. Then Engelbert, and remember the Frenchman who started from way back on the back of the grid, number 77, now into the top 10 in eighth place. And he's passed Andrea Palmer, who is so difficult to pass, believe me, I've seen him. Then Taniguchi in 10th place, Burudinov in 11th, Jack Rattenbury. His pit stop must have worked very well indeed, because he's pushed himself all the way through the order into the middle of the pack in 12th place, into the point. Zen Low, who's just taken over from Dilantha, the Sri Lankan, he's in 13th place. Polichuk in 14th. Tom O'Gara now into 15th place. He's in front of Kevin Conway as well. And Tom O'Gara is the amateur driver. Kevin Conway, the only driver in his car, will need to do a lot better than that. So we're starting to look at the times. Now, Federico De Nora, 154.4. Now, that's his first flying lap. But Andrea Amici, 149.3. And he's well up to speed on what's going on here. So it's very, very shortly that Andrea Amici, number 54, will take over the lead. The gap between them is 6.5 seconds. Yep, 6.5 seconds between first and second at the moment. So just a couple of laps needed for Andrea Amici to close right down. The two on screen at the moment, and I think Andrea Amici's already got past him. Number 27 that we're looking at is Andrea Palma. Andrea Palma down in ninth place at light blue car. And there it is, we're seeing them in the infield as they come in. Andrea Amici, well, there was a big gap that he needed to close down, but Andrea Amici's done it, and he's passed Federico Di Nora, so it's now gone into the lead. The Auto Carrozzeria Imperiale Lamborghini and the pro driver Andrea Amici in the lead. They're very, very close together, though. So Federico Di Nora and the Bernaldi Lamborghini behind him, as they will come into the Roma curve, come across the stripe, and those two top positions will change. Across the stripe, number 54, Andrea Amici, behind him, number 3, Federico Di Nora. Then Gagliardini from the composite team, the black and silver machine behind him. Andrew Palmer's gone up into fourth place, so he's still chasing Gagliardini, but he's quite a way behind him at the moment, over 3 seconds down on Gagliardini. So the pit stop hasn't really done much to help his cause for Andrew Palmer. He's got quite a bit to close up now on Gagliardini, and I don't think he's going to be able to do it now. Fourth is good, but he would love a podium. I can tell you this, the youngster who came in to Virginia International Raceway and surprised everybody by taking pole and a race win and fourth in the second race. And he's feeling his oats here, I can tell you. Car still slipping around, and because we're still getting light rain here, well, I wouldn't call it light. I'd call it light in 169. Just almost pulled in while he was coming down the pit lane. That's Tom Agara now, who's gone out. So Tom Agara, not too sure where he's going while he was coming out of a pit lane. He's a North American amateur champion, so he's not slow. But James Sofronas, who he drives with, is the team owner. And that's a brand new team for them. No, it's not. Sorry, it's Global Motorsports Group. I was looking at Change Racing. It's Kevin Conway, which is the brand new team. Now we look at the red and silver machine, who's still within sight. That's Andrew Palmer in fourth place. He's still within sight of Gagliardini, but Gagliardini's closed right up on Federico Di Nora now, and just coming down the main straight. He's right behind him, angling for a pass. And there's nothing that Andrew Palmer can do about that. He will try, but he won't be able to close up on him. It's quite possible that Gagliardini will now go into second place. We're seeing Andrea Amici out in front, number 54. And you can see the sodden ground around this track. It's been raining, we've had thunderstorms. Last night was some really heavy rain. The night before that was thunderstorms. Pit stop for somebody over there. There's a couple of cars already in the pits. On your screen, the leader around here, Andrea Amici, out in front. And really starting to open that gap. Sun starting to shine in through the windows now. We're scrabbling around trying to put some covers in front of the monitors so that we can see what's going on. Andrea Amici and Federico Di Nora behind him, Andrea Gagliardini, and it is Gagliardini just in the car. It says Delonte there as well, but he's not. Drive-through penalty for number 99 and 212. So Mikhail Spiridonov has got a drive-through penalty, along with somebody's just pulled up. That's right at the bottom of the Tolentino hairpin. Not too sure who it is at the moment. It is Di Nora. That's Federico Di Nora, who's just come off at the bottom, so he's lost a lot of time, and that's helped a lot of people, because with Di Nora going down, that means Gagliardini is in second place. Andrew Palmer will have moved up to third place. So Andrew Palmer looking like he's on for a podium here at the moment with Manabu Orido. He's just gone into fourth place. Alberto Viberti might have even passed him as well. So Federico Nora, just a little bit too much of the lead foot. And off of the Tolentino hairpin, one of the tightest little hairpins, tightest little corners on any track I've been to. And certainly caught him out, the amateur driver. We'll see when they come across the line. Sun now really starting to shine. But we won't have a dry line in this race at all because it's still spitting with rain out there, even though the sun is starting to shine. Makes a change over the past 3 days because we haven't seen the sun at all. Andrea Amici still out in the lead, though. A lot of things changing here. Gagliardini now showing on the timing monitors as into second place, and Andrew Palmer third, and a podium for him in Italy. He'll love that indeed. And I think Andrew Palmer is right behind Gagliardini at the moment. Having a look down at Tolentino hairpin as they come up through the S's and down to Roma. And I think that gap has really closed down now. Gagliardini, less than a second, and I think he's right on his tail, and I think he's gone up the inside at Roma. Gagliardini tried to turn into him, took them both out. And it looks like second and third places are both out at the Roma curve. We're not seeing that on the picture at the moment, but that is... My goodness. Palmer been able to get away with that, but Gagliardini, don't know where he is at the moment. While I was looking at Palmer going through, I think Gagliardini, I'm not sure, we'll have to see, because the bridge is in the way. We look down the main straight, and there's the Autodromo Vallelonga bridge that goes across there. Gagliardini, that's 47, which isn't him. That's Alberto Viberti. So Viberti's gone through in fifth place. But it might be even higher than that. We'll have to see. Well, because it just came unsighted from us as Andrew Palmer was going up the inside of Gagliardini, trying to get that second place, almost got it as well, but Gagliardini turned in front of him, caught the front of the car, it turned Gagliardini around, but I don't think it hurt Andrew Palmer too much and was able to take avoiding action. 2-1-2 is just coming through the pit lane. That's Top Speed Racing's Yukinori Taniguchi. Yukinori actually is a video game developer. He made all his money from inventing a video game in his bedroom. Just made a complete million for himself. DNF'd, but also had a third in Malaysia. He's not a bad driver at all. Safety car's just gone out onto the track. So flashing lights from the pace car have just gone out. There's a yellow being shown on the start and finish line. So I think we're running under safety car at the moment. Things happening around the track that we're not seeing. We've got these tiny little 7-inch monitors which the sun is shining in at the moment, but not too much that we can see about that. Wavy yellow flags on the start and finish straight, which means, and somebody's holding out the board, which means the safety car is out on the track. 1-1-4. So Andrew Palmer does get into second place. Andrea Amici still in first by a long way as well. 7.3 seconds is Andrea Amici leading this race. Manabu Orido, top of the Asians. So it's worked out very well indeed for all three series, because all three series, the North American, the European, and the Asian series, all have podium places currently in the state of the race. But we are under safety car conditions at the moment. Alberto Viberti's managed to help himself to fourth place from that. And Engelbert, the Frenchman, Dimitri Engelbert from France, from the back row of the grid, up into fifth place at the moment. Federico De Nora showing in sixth place. Andrea Palma, the Italian, in seventh place. Not Andrew Palmer. That's why the confusion reigns here. Zanardi down in eighth place. Taniguchi in ninth place. Jake Rattenbury into the top 10 now, the Brit. The youngster in 10th place. It's Peridinov, Polishuk, and Zin Lo, 13th. Gagliardini in 14th, Kevin Conway still in 15th place, but in front of Tom O'Gara now, which you would expect from the professional driver and the amateur. But Tom O'Gara, O'Gara Coachworks in California. In fact, Tom O'Gara, I think, also has a dealership for Beverly Hills Lamborghini. So there's quite a little bit of money involved in Lamborghini in Beverly Hills, and that's Tom O'Gara. But he's down, he's still in the top 15, no, he's just outside the top 15 in 16th place. So it's Capra, Mori, Severso, Roberto Tanca, and still showing Shota Abkazova in 21st place, but he's out, and I think Nakaya is out as well. So as the pace car comes through around Cerrato, Semaforo, which is Italian actually for traffic lights. So the Semaforo curve, and then they're going down that really, really tight Tornantino. As we look on the start-finish straight, number 169 going through, it's Tom O'Gara. As I said, he's in 16th place at the moment. So we do have pit lane reporters, but of course, it seems that I'm not getting any communication from them at all. So Clive Ritchie, Daniele Cariotti, if you can hear me and if you can get in somehow, it will be nice indeed, so we can find out what's going on down there. So under pace car, as they come down the Roma curve. Only 3 minutes left on the race, and this could actually finish under the pace car. But he really has put everybody together here. And although there are cars in front of Andrew Palmer, number 114, it's not the positions they are in the track, because the cars in front of him have been lapped. So if you're watching the pace car, first driver, Andrea Amici. We've got a couple of drivers behind him. The fourth car along is number 114, which is Andrew Palmer. And Andrew Palmer in second place at the moment. There's one car who's going very, very slowly around the infield and has yet to catch any of the cars behind him. Don't know who it is at the moment. Trying to find out who is it. We're just looking down the list. We've got a lot of help here. Oh, it's Tom O'Gara. So number 169, Tom O'Gara. He seems to be driving a coach at the moment. He has his own coach works, but he's driving so slowly.
He's 62
years old. He's 62. Somebody just told me he's 60 years old. He's 62, but saying that doesn't matter. He is not slow. You've got to remember that this guy, Tom O'Gara,
from
look, Tom O'Gara, he's the North American amateur champion. He's had some good results. So... so don't sniff at me, as one of the Italian commentators at my side is going, hey, he's 60 years old and he's driving it like a bus. No, this guy is good, Tom O'Gara. And the checkered flag is out, so it looks like we're going to finish this race under safety car. And it looks like the positions are going to be as follows. Andrea Amici did what he needed to do. He held back Adrian Zaug in front of him and stopped Adrian from getting too much of a gap in front of him. And then when Federico Di Nora took over, Federico had his own problems. Eventually, he was passed by Andrea Amici and then had a big off at the top of the Roma curve. And Andrea Palmer, when Andrea Palmer was trying to pass him up the inside, The man with the checkered flag is there waiting. He's not hanging it out at the moment. We might get another lap in, but I'm not too sure. Because, as I said about 2 minutes ago, we had 3 minutes left. Might get another lap in. Don't think they'll be able to. But who knows? We'll see as they come across the stripe. Andrea Amici still under safety car here. And I think Tom O'Gara is starting to catch the back, finally, from the back. So he will be with them when they come across the stripe, just coming through the Tornantino hairpin as the leaders come into the Roma curve, still under the safety car, and the man with the checkered flag is waiting for them. So they will be finishing under the safety car, but still it will be the finish of the race, and Andrea Amici will have won this because there's no passing under yellows. He's still got it filled. So there will be one more lap. There'll be one more lap to go. So, but they'll still be under safety car. Safety car will still lead them around from this. And a wavy yellow flag, there'll be no more passing at all. And Andrea Amici will stay where he is in the lead of this race. They look for number 54. Six overall wins this year in the Super Trofeo Europe. And he's a young guy as well. So it's the youngsters who are winning here today. 20-year-old Andrea Amici. As I said, born in Albano, Lazio, which is just over there. And Piero Taruffi came from the same place as well. And he's a track designer. So, of course, it had to be Andrea Amici who won. But it is really, really good to know that all three series are competitive at a track that the Italians know so well. They come over here from North America. Hey, what is this, man? You know, what is this track here? It's not an oval. I don't know what's going on. Maybe Kevin Conway is just used to driving around ovals all the time. But one person that impressed me so much is Andrew Palmer, who's come over here. He's raced some of the best people. He came into racing at Virginia International Raceway after driving karts. And he's quick in karts, but you put him in a kart for the very, very first time. He'd never driven a race car before. And you put him in one at Virginia International Raceway. And he took pole, and he took a win. In the second race, he got fourth. And he's got a second place here in a car, which he designed the color scheme himself, so his dad, David, said. In second place for him, it's been absolutely brilliant. And Manabu Orido, Max Orido, number 263. We're going to have a look at the information on Max, because now this is very interesting. Max, one of the Japanese guys here. There he is, 45 years old. 45 years old. He's from Chiba in Japan. He's in third place. He'll cross the line as the checkered flag goes out. He currently competes in Super GT Series for the Toyota team Tsuchiya in a Lexus SC430, sponsored by Eclipse and Advance. I would say that. Cross the finish line they go. There was still safety car pulled in, but it didn't matter because nobody was going to be able to pass in that short time from Roma to here. And Andrea Amici takes the win. Andrew Palmer in second. And Max Manabu Orido in third place. Pro driver. He had a 10th and a 5th with Johnson Yaptenaga, his Indonesian teammate at Fuji. But this has been by far his best result. Began his racing career as a street racer and progressed to touring car racing. And he's now racing in the Japanese Super GT Series. But Andrea Amici, the 20-year-old, has had a brilliant little race here and done everything he needed to do to take the win. So Andrea Amici from Andrew Palmer, number 54, versus number 114. And I'll get all the information for you at the moment that we have. So, there we go. Oh, dear. 20-year-old versus 19-year-old, first and second, versus a 45-year-old who comes across the line in third for his best result of the season so far. This has been a good race here and a surprising race as well, with Federico Di Nora really trying hard to keep Andrew Palmer behind him at the Roma curve, turned into him. Andrew Palmer got caught in that, but was able, had enough noose in his head, knew exactly what he needed to do to avoid him and carry on going. You needed to keep going, not sit there and go, oh, he hit me. And he carried on going, and it's been absolutely brilliant for him as well. But Andrea Amici, 2011, made his debut at 17 years old in the Porsche Carrera Cup in Italy, the World Championship Porsche Super Cup at Monza. In conjunction with Formula One, got two wins in the league Targa Tricolore Porsche. Now, last year, he was in the Lamborghini Super Trofeo Europe with 5 wins and 10 podiums. Also won the Bologna Motor Show in the GT Category Cup. And European champion this year with 6 wins out of 10 races. Well, he can add to that with yet another win. Andrea Amici, absolutely brilliant for him. Andrew Palmer, second place, 19-year-old from Chicago. And remember, this guy's in his first year at uni. He's just started university. He's studying mathematics and economics. This guy's got a level head. You know, he's not an art student, not a media studies. No, maths and economics. You can't get tougher than that. And Dad David said he's got a very strong head on his shoulders, but he is still a kid, so he designed his own car, designed the color scheme for the car, so it's red and chrome. Yeah, it's flames, baby. He's, as I said, he never competed in a car race before this year. Karting standout. He wrapped up the weekend's fourth Lamborghini Super Trofeo Series victory at Virginia International Raceway. Won the national karting title in 2010 and followed that up with a load of domestic and international podiums. Driving number 14 Thermal Club Lamborghini, this is the official report, drove a remarkable march, they said, to win at Virginia. Andrea Amici, and look at that, everybody's out of the car and giving him congratulations. Well, so they should as well. This is the European champion, and he's at home, and he needed to lead those cars back in, and that's what he did. Andrea Amici, winner of race one here at Vallelonga for the first of the two world final races that we've got for you in the Lamborghini Blancpain Super Trofeo Series. And I can tell you this, that nobody here is actually looking at the monitors. We're looking down at the scenes in pit lane at the moment. And it's been a brilliant ride for them as well. Alberto Viberti is there as well, but not a podium for him. It's just Amici, and I'll write all these down, Amici, Palmer, and Orido in first, second, and third. I always say, you know, if you something is so obvious, and if you don't write it down, you'll forget it, even though it is so obvious. If you see Andrew Palmer's car, the chrome and red, I mean, you really do want to stand out. But even in this company, in world-class company, you don't stand out, especially with the Japanese designers as well. The one of the cars behind him is just trying to look at the number at the moment. People standing in front of me, it's difficult to see what number it is, but I do know it's one of the Japanese competitors, and the design on that is the yellow car, number the fourth one along from the front, is... It might be, yes, that's Manabu Arido's, the yellow car, which is the some of the Japanese designs on there, which is fairly intricate and quite typically Japanese. So no smooth flowing lines, lots of cartoon characters and strange lettering on it. So Max Arido, and he'll be really pleased with that indeed. Well, Max. Johnson Yaptenaga out first for him, and Manabu taking over. Sorry, Manabu first of all for him, and that was Johnson Yaptenaga taking over. So do apologise, Johnson, the Indonesian, because it was him who brought the car home. So Yaptenaga met him a little bit earlier on. Really nice guy, young guy, and they're all really nice guys. You know, that's the thing about it. You have a look at Andrew Johnson, a really nice guy. You know, Andrea Amici, he's a really nice guy. They're all good. They don't have... their noses in the air when they go past you. These are some of the top drivers around, amateurs and pro, and they put a lot of money into this. You had to buy your car to come in, then pay your entry fee for the race. And for a one-make series, the Lamborghini Blancpain Super Trofeo is shown us some fantastic racing throughout the year. And it's good to know that the people who've really, really pushed hard for this, Andrea Amici, as I said, European champion, and he's had to do this win at home, and very clever for him to do it as well. The main thing that he needed to do was keep Adrian Zelg within view. Adrian Zelg, we've seen him throughout the season going out and taking pole positions and really getting fast laps. If it was just him in the car, Andrea would have had a lot tougher time of it, I can tell you. But as luck would have it, this time it was Federico De Nora who took over from Adrian after maintaining that lead over Andrea Amici. And then, of course, he lost it within about two laps when the amateur took over. So all good stuff. And for all this time, we've got two pit lane reporters who I don't know what they've been doing. I don't know if they've been able to hear me at all, but certainly didn't able to get hold of those. And I would have loved to have had them to do the interviews on the podium, because Amici, well, yeah, that would have been great. But to get Andrew Palmer and Max Arrigo up there as well and get interviews with them, that would have been absolutely stunning. Hopefully things will be sorted for race two. And, of course, we're going to be back for race two. But at the moment, the driver's just coming up and being told where to go by the organisers so that they can get the podium done and dusted. And, of course, they'll have the champagne up there and not allowed to drink any of it because they've got another race to go. You know, you can't go out there and say, oh, this is really good. Maybe you can just wet your whistle a little bit, but you can't drink too much of it. And so we're waiting to see the podium for these top three finishers. There's a lot of the other cars have gone into Parc Fermé. And these guys will go a little bit later on. Of course, the cars all checked to make sure there's no trickery gone on with them. But they're all run by Lamborghini. Any problems with the cars are sorted by Lamborghini. As I said, Jake Rattenbury had a really good result on that as well because he came in the top 10 and they needed to change a gearbox. And when they changed the gearbox, I found out that it probably wasn't the gearbox, it was something else. It got Lamborghini on it, they sorted it. Jake was out this morning running around and making sure that everything was fine with that, which it was. And he's come from the back row of the grid into 10th place. So lots of things to look at here. Kevin Conway, we expected a lot more from the North American champion, down in 14th place. So obviously the handling problems that he'd had with his car hadn't been sorted throughout the race. Tom O'Gara in 15th place, so he was up into the top 15. Gagliardini down into 16th place. Max Arrigo, the 45-year-old Japanese driver, in third place. Manubu, we call him Max. He even has that on his race overall, I think. He's got Max somewhere on it because that's how he's known. Andrew Palmer, well, this has been good for him. Dad David sits there all the time in contact with his driver. And there it is, European champion. And race one winner in the world final, Andrea Amici, 20 years old, two kids on the podium and a 45-year-old. How about that? You have a look at what Andrea Amici's done, just as 20, from 20 years old. And the sheet that I've got on race places and race series goes into two sheets. So it's the national anthem for Italy. Finishes, Andrea Amici can put his cap back on again. As I said, just before the national anthem started, his rap sheet goes on forever. Formula 2000 Lights Italy, Formula Renault 2, Switzerland, Italy, Seat Leon Super Cup, Italy, Porsche Carrera Cup, and now Lamborghini Trofeo, Italian GT. And this guy's only 20 years old. You know, you think, shouldn't you think of a good career like going to university or something? No, not if you're as good as Andrea Amici, 20 years old. Super Trofeo Europe Pro-Am champion, 6 overall wins this year. And yet another in the world final in front of everybody from the North American Series and the Asian Series to take this. And Andrew Palmer. Ah, Andrea Amici's father is just underneath. It's one of the Italian commentators just pointed me. It's a gentleman with glasses, just walking just below on the just below us on the grandstand. His hands in his pockets because it's still quite chilly out there. Looking at his son on the podium, that's lovely. Champagne goes out, and Andrew Palmer giving it a good shake as well. Max Arrivo. And everybody cheering each other and having a little swig. Max Arrivo just lose a little bit of his. And well, that's it for race one here at Vallelunga. Race two will be coming up a little bit later on live. Keep with us and keep online because we're online as well. The Lamborghini Blancpain Super Trofeo Series will be back with the second and final race of the world final here at Vallelunga a little bit later on. Till then, bye-bye for now.